Welcome to Jersey Guy Sports, your sports talk home for the Yanks, the Giants, the Rangers, and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. And I'm your host, Don. I want to thank you for listening. On this unhappy Jersey Guy podcast today, I'll be discussing Aaron Judge, who is costing the Yanks the World Series as the Yankees fall 4-2 in Game 2 of the World Series. So let's start. So the Yankees lost 4-2 Saturday night to the Dodgers after barely resembling a major league team that can hit the ball through 8 innings, as Jersey Guy's sports weekend from hell continued. The Yanks did make it interesting in the 9th, but ultimately they lost 4-2, and the Dodgers took a 2-0 series lead in the World Series. Carlos Rodon sucked balls. He gave up 3 home runs in his World Series debut and really just sucked. Juan Soto was great, as always. He tied the game 1-1 with a homer, and then he got the Yankees' second hit of the whole game in the 9th. Stanton did his part, continued his strong playoffs. He got a key clutch 9th inning RBI. But the Yanks didn't end up having enough in the 9th inning. Even after they load the bases with one out, down now 4-2, Volpe ended up striking out, and Trevino was a pinch hitter, flew out fairly deep to end the game. Through 8 innings, the Yankees' offense, frankly, was offensive. The Yanks managed only one single hit, and that was Soto's home run through 8 innings. I mean, that's how utterly incompetent the Yankees were hitting the ball. But unfortunately, none of that is what this podcast will be devoted to. What I'm going to talk to this podcast and talk about is leading the charge in hitting incompetence was Aaron Judge again. The Aaron Judge who has become the all-time king of underperforming in the playoffs at this point. And I'm sorry to people that this offends, but too fucking bad. Judge managed to strike out 3 more fucking times on Saturday. And now has become, in my mind, the G-Coat. Not the GOAT, but the greatest choke artist of all time. The G-Coat. I mean, is that hyperbole? Yeah, maybe it is still. But on Saturday, what is the date today? October 26, 2024. It doesn't feel like fucking hyperbole. It feels like he is the greatest choke artist of all time. Judge went 0-4 in Game 2 with 3 more goddamn strikeouts and sunk to, where is it? 6-40. This postseason. 6-40. That's a 150 average, including now 1-9 in the World Series. This postseason so far, he has 19 strikeouts. I mean, just awful. Judge has had the opportunity in many of the games, you know, to kind of set the tone early in the first inning, especially. He's gotten up with, you know, runners on and a scoring opportunity in the first inning. 9 of the 11 postseason games, right? So in the very first inning, Judge Zapanaris had an opportunity with runners in scoring position or runners on base anyway, 9 of 11 times. He's 0-9 in those spots with runners on base with 6 strikeouts. And that includes the first inning Saturday night against Yamamoto. 0-9 just in the first inning with runners on. You talk about choking. All told, Judge is 0-10 with runners in scoring position this October with 6 strikeouts. I mean, that's suck-ass defined, choking defined. It feels like Aaron Judge has just shrunk over and over and over in the big moments in the playoffs, and he's choking in every single big spot imaginable. And it's not just this year either, but it seems worse and worse this year. He did this the last time the Yankees made the playoffs. He has not been good in the postseason, and it's almost unimaginable, especially for someone who is a big Aaron Judge fan. And it's hard to watch, but I'm tired of shying away from it, and it just has to be said, right? Now, the Yanks could have easily won Game 1 had Judge done anything at all in the 9th inning or in any of his other at-bats. He had a chance to in the 9th to win the game for the Yanks in Game 1. He popped out after striking out 3 other times in Game 1. choking in the spotlight, just as he has for most of his postseason career. Now, Aaron Judge's legacy is just about, I don't know, irrevocably diminished at this point, in my mind. Unless some miracle occurs over the next couple games and Judge somehow manages to turn this fucking shit around, Aaron Judge's legacy is irrevocably diminished, and I'm sorry. He's going to be, in my mind, worse than A-Rod, who, you know, at least had that one great postseason in 2009, where Judge really hasn't done anything to carry the Yanks anywhere in the playoffs, and if anything, has been even worse than A-Rod in the postseason, just completely collapsing and crushing like a flower in the big spot. It's beyond astonishing for me that such a great hitter can wither just so obviously, so pathetically in these big spots. And it drives me nuts. And it's just, it's almost cringeworthy to watch when he gets up now, because you can feel it as a viewer. You can see that his timing is off, right? He's too fast on the curveballs. He's missing curveballs by 6 inches or a foot. He's late on fastballs. His timing is off. It's just, it's painful to watch, you know, and Boone, being who Boone is, will never, ever do anything to change it. He will not move him out of the three hole. He will not change anything up. We'll just end up losing this World Series because, you know, Judge is our three hitter. We must keep him there. You know, Boone is going to be Boone. And, you know, Boone will continue talking his happy horse shit right through our World Series loss this year if nothing changes. Yeah, I felt he had a strong at-bat against this guy or that guy, or he looked like he was right on it. I mean, it's beyond obnoxious at this point for anyone to be supporting Aaron Judge's play in the postseason. I mean, as good as he has been in the regular season, and he has been better than just about anyone, he has been probably the single worst postseason performer of anyone on any team. Do I need to go through the stats again? 6-for-40. 1-for-9 in the World Series. He has 19 fucking strikeouts this postseason. Every single big spot he chokes. Every single big spot. Some players are made for the moment. Some players are not. Clearly, Aaron Judge is not made for the moment. Juan Soto, more than anyone is, certainly more than anyone I've ever seen except for Derek Jeter in my mind, Juan Soto is made for the moment. Stanton certainly is made for the playoffs. As much of a problem as I have with him in most of the regular seasons, and I do, but you've heard it on these podcasts, I lay into Stanton left and right in the regular season because he's, you know, not great. But in the postseason, year after year, Giancarlo Stanton has stepped up, and this is another year. He had a big RBI in the ninth year. Soto had a home run. He had two more hits. Stanton and Soto are made for the big moments. Aaron Judge has shown over years and years of playoff futility that he is not. I'm fucking tired of saying this on podcasts at this point, but there's no getting around it. Aaron Judge is a choke artist in the playoffs, and now his awful hitting seems likely to cost the Yankees a possible World Series unless something fucking gets turned around really soon. And it's just, I want to bang my head at this point. The Yankees play Game 3 at home in the Bronx Monday night. Opposite the New York Giants, by the way. Monday night, you can turn on the Giants and you can turn on the Yankees in the World Series. Monday night, they play at home in a game that the Yankees critically need to remain alive in the series. So, we need Clark Schmidt to give us a really good start on Monday night and get us back in the series here. And Aaron Judge may not get booed by the fans at home Monday night, but rest assured, he's getting booed by this fan. That's it. That's going to do it for my podcast. Thank you for listening to Jersey Guy Sports. Please subscribe to the podcast. Tell your friends all about it. I'll be back soon with some more sports talk. Thanks. Have a good day.